I think what we'll do now, I think let's try to just work on the tutorial. Let's do the tutorial maybe in 10 minutes or 15 minutes. So the tutorial problem is displayed. So any of the centers, if you can give me IZ or IY, or maybe just try to first get the IX. So again, I'll give a quick hint. So it's a cone, and then again we have to take a thin disk as an element. So there will be a thin disk, let's say at a distance x. So thickness of that disk will be dx. So just look at the lecture problem slides. So can we do that way? And remember, the radius of that disk at a distance x, that has to be a function of x as well. So represent the r in terms of x in that disk. Yeah, some of you are giving the correct answers. Ix, I see here on the chat, answer is correct, 3 by 10 m a square. So answer is 3 over 10 m a square. How about the Iy and Iz? Any center? First of all, Iy should be equals to Iz, that is one thing. I think 1, 2, 2, 4, yeah, some of those centers are giving. Just take your time, I think these are, deliver it to students especially, that how to look at these problems are going to be challenging. Yes, I think I have the answer for now. IY, IZ is also coming up, so those are correct. So the solution is displayed, it will be also posted on the Moodle. You look at your video, solution is there. As I said, the basis will be, the basis is really to construct this. See, ultimately everything lies here, how to construct this thin slab or thin disk. Okay, and we know already that what are the mass moment of inertia about three perpendicular axes. So you see that R is represented by A multiplied by x over h, right? So that's the main basis, and ultimately the answer, I don't know if it will be clear, but here you have the answer for Ix, 3 by 10 m a square. Similarly, remember, for when we are doing the IY, right, so IY prime, we can calculate DIY prime, and then we have to look at the parallel axis theorem to go to the Y. So the final answer, as some of you are giving already, that's the final answer, 3 by 5 m 1 by 4 a square plus h square. So let's move on to the next problem, just a quick problem we are going to do. So for this assembly, we have to find out the mass moment of inertia about the y axis. Now that's the easiest part actually, about the y axis when the body is rotating. So what we'll do, we'll try to quickly find out the y axis, and then other two, I'll post the solution, so please look at it. Okay, so I just need the result for the y axis for the time being. And the x and z axis, we can do at as an homework exercise. So there is a cutout here, 20 mm radius, that cutout is there, and we have a cylinder here connected. So I just need the answer for the first part, that is y axis, and then we can do the rest of it, as an exercise later on. So now let's look at the solution. As such, it is not a complicated problem at all. So if you go by the solution, the approach would be, So, it has to be discretized into three bodies as you see here, 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So, 1 is that complete solid disk, 2 is the cylinder and 3 is that cutout, okay, in the form of a, let us say, cylinder. Okay. So, ultimately we have the mass m 1, m 2 and m 3 of these three bodies. And then remember that the first one, that means first body, you can get it m r square over 2. So, that is very simple. For the total body, total solid body, it is m r square over 2. Similarly, all of these has actually m r square over 2 about its own centroidal axis, right? All of these bodies about their own centroidal axis, that is y axis, the mass moment of inertia about the y axis of individual centroid is always m r square over 2. Now, for body number 2 and body number 3, we need to use the parallel axis theorem. Okay. So, ultimately that is done if you look at it carefully. So, the body number 1 is m r square over 2, body 2 m r square over 2 plus mass times d square, and body number 3 needs to be subtracted because this one is already considered as solid. Body 1 is considered as solid. So, ultimately final answer is 20.6 10 to the power minus 3 kg meter square. Okay. Thank you.